Hello viewers, today's lesson is on major historical approaches to early childhood education. The objective of this lesson is to understand the different approaches to early childhood care and education. So, under this lesson, we are going to deal with the program's history and what is the main components to each of these historical approach and what is the uniqueness about the program. Module 1, Introduction. As early childhood educators, we all have our own philosophies and approaches to education. Our approach to teaching is created from a multitude of resources and probably includes a knowledge from early childhood theories, an understanding of child development, and our experiences with children in different learning environments. Whether a new teacher about to embark her teaching and on early childhood care as well as a seasoned professional, it is helpful to know what other educators are doing in different types of programs. New approaches to teaching and learning can be adopted within our own environment, and information about how our philosophy of education compares or differs from others can be shared with the parents who are considering your program for their children. Early childhood education models, they represent a cohort approach to working with children, including the philosophical and theoretical base, goals, curriculum designs, methods, and evaluation procedures. The education of the early childhood models from 1906 to 1970s, the approaches included the environment, the children, the teachers, the materials, and the curriculum. The historical approaches to early childhood education models from 1906 to 1970s included the children, the environment, the teachers, the curriculum, and the materials. Of all the major educational approaches, the first and the main important one is the Montessori method. Maria Montessori, the Italy's first woman physician, opened her first school in 1907. The Montessori school in the United States opened in 1911, and by 1916, the Montessori method was found in locations across the world. The use of natural observation in a prepared environment by an objective teacher led by Montessori to consider her method scientifically. After Montessori completed her direct study of the children, she specified every particular detail of her own school, and it should be operated in to ensure the accurate replications. The teacher's role in Montessori school is to observe in order to connect the child with suitable material. Let us now see what are the main components in Montessori method. First, let us look after the social component. The link between the family and school is important. The most Montessori classrooms have multi-age groups, which is intended to give children more opportunity to learn from each other. Montessori advocated that the children learn best by doing. In order to help children focus, the teacher silently demonstrates the use of learning material to learn. The children may then choose to practice on any material they have to learn about. Once the children are given the lessons with the materials, they may work on it independently, and often they have to designate their spaces. Now, let us have a look at the curriculum of Montessori. Module 2, the curriculum of Montessori method. In curriculum, it included the touching, seeing, smelling, tasting, and exploring than just by learning. The child's work was a purposeful, ordered activity towards a determined end is highly valued in this method. This applies both to the exercises of practical life and as well as language. The main material in the classroom are the didactic. That means these materials involve the sensory experiences and are self-correcting. The Montessoris are designed aesthetically pleasing yet they are very sturdy and were developed by Maria Montessori herself to help the children develop the organization. Events summarized that the preschool curriculum in Montessori program as consisting of three broad phases of exercises for practical life, that is the sensory education and the language activity, which includes both reading and writing. Then next comes the environmental setup. The environmental setup in the Montessori method is that the Montessori believed that environment should be prepared by matching the child's level to the corresponding didactic material. The environment should be comfortable for the children. That means that environment should be child friendly, the child sized chairs that are of lightweight. The environment should be home like, so that the children can learn, practice the life issues. For example, there should be a place for the children to practice proper self-help skills such as wash handing. Since Montessori believed the beauty helped with the concentration, the setting is aesthetically pleasing to the eyes. And in the setting, each child is provided a place to keep his or her own belongings. Now, let us see what is the uniqueness of this program. In this Montessori method, the environment is prepared with the self-correcting material for work and not for play. The Montessori method seeks to support the child in the organization, thus pretend play and opportunities to learn creatively from errors are less likely to be seen in the Montessori classroom. The Piaget, often called as the father of constructivism, and the Montessori method agreed that the children learn from errors, and yet the setup in which the errors may occur is controlled and the error versus with the adult correcting the child. The classrooms are organized in this method. There are distinct areas which contain materials to be mastered in that area. It is set up to be aesthetically pleasing with plants, flowers and attractive furnishing materials. In Montessori, each classroom has different ages involved in the individual activities. The children are free to engage in which projects they like to choose. The younger children participated in some activities to imitate their older classmates. The teacher. In Montessori system, the involvement of the teacher is unobstructive and quiet. She may be observing from a distance or sometimes demonstrating to a child how to use a new material. The teacher do not reinforce or praise the children for their work. Then come to the materials. Materials have a specific characteristics. In Montessori method, the materials are didactic and they are designed to teach a specific lesson. The materials are self-correcting, they are simple to complex, and the materials are often natural and mostly they are made up of the wood. The second set of activities and sensorial are helping the child to develop, organize, broaden and refine sensory perceptions of sight, sound, smell and taste. And the third aspect of this program involves conceptual academic materials. The conceptual learning activities are concrete and actively involve the child in a multi-sensory ways. So, this is all about the Montessori approach towards the early childhood education. After Montessori approach, let's have a look at the high or scope approach. Module 3, the high or scope approach. The high or scope was founded in 1970 by the work of the Dave Wiechart and Coney, who worked on the Perry Preschool project. This project was initiated in the year 1962 and involved the teachers working with the children from the age group of 3 to 4 years old. A few hours a day at a school and attending the staff meetings and making a weekly home visits. The program was developed with the idea that early childhood education can prevent the school failure in high school students and from some of the poorest areas. The Perry Preschool Program is one of the few longitudinal studies in early childhood education field, and it has got a significant findings. For instance, compared with the matched control group, the children that were a part of this Perry Preschool Program had significantly more high school graduates and fewer under dropouts. Although both constructivism and Montessori method involved learning by doing, there are significant differences. In Montessori, for instance, the didactic self-correcting material are specifically designed to help prevent the errors. The children here learn by repetition instead of the trial and error method. The role pretended to of play is also different in these two methods. In high or the scope, the children's creative exploration is encouraged, and this sometimes led to the pretend play, while in Montessori, the practical life work that relates to the real world is stressed. In the high or scope approach, it includes times of various grouping experiences in the classroom. There are specific periods in each day for small group times and for large group times, and for the children to play independently in the learning centers throughout the classroom. In this approach, the children are encouraged to share their thinking with the teachers and peers. The social interactions in the classroom community are encouraged. The teacher facilitates the work on the problem resolution with the children as whenever the conflict arises. When the child talks, the teacher listens and asks open-ended questions. They seek to ask questions that encourage children to express their thoughts, be creative, and rather than having a closed questions. Each day in high scope, teacher observes and records what the children are doing. During the year, the teacher completes a high scope child observation record from the daily observations they have collected. Now, coming to the curriculum part of this high or scope approach. In curriculum part, the key experiences are designed specifically for this approach. The key experiences for the preschool children include the creative representation, classification, language, seriation, initiativeness, social relation, the number, movement, space, music, and time. The curriculum includes plan, do, review. It is another major component of this high or scope approach framework. The children in this approach are encouraged to plan the area, the materials, and the methods they are going to work with. The children actually carry out their own plan and review and articulate the classroom community, what they are actually doing during the time. The review time helps the children bring closure to their work and link their actual work to their plan. This curriculum approach also includes the cleanup time, which is a natural part of the plan, do, review. The children are given a sense of control by cleaning up. Representative labels help the children to return the material to the appropriate places. The high or the scope classrooms has a consistent routine. The purpose of resulting in predictability is to help the children understand what will happen next and encourage them to have more control in their classroom. The environmental setup. The environmental setup in high or the scope approach is the material rich learning environment. The location of classroom material are labeled to help the children learn organizational skills. The materials are set up so that they are easily accessible at a child's level, and this helps the children to actively explore the material and the environment. The teacher sets up the classroom areas purposefully for the children to explore, build social relationship, and often with the well-defined areas for different activities. This is about the high or scope approach. After the Maria Montessori method of early childhood education and high or scope approach towards early childhood education, let us now look at the another important historical approaches to the early childhood education. Module 4, the Reggio Emilia approach. It was started by the Loris, who was the teacher himself, and the parents around the Reggio Emilia in the Italy during the World War II. The philosophy of this approach: children must have some control over the direction of their learning. The children must be able to learn through experiences of touching, moving, listening, seeing, and hearing. The children have a relationship with other children and with the material items in the world that the children must be allowed to explore. The children must have endless ways of opportunities to express themselves. The components of this approach includes cooperation and collaboration. These are the terms that stress the value of revisiting the social learning. First, the children become a members of community that is working together, which is nothing but a cooperation. Once there is a foundation of trust between the children and adults, the constructive conflict may be helpful in gaining the new insights, which is nothing but the collaborations. Though the co-construction refers to the fact that the meaning of experiences is often built in a social context. The teacher has a special training which is supporting the curriculum and the development of the children and other faculty members. In each of these Reggio Emilia primary schools, they are built as a part of the carefully planned support system. The teacher is a part of this carefully planned support system, and the school community has a connection between them. Coming to the curriculum part, one of the special features of this approach is called as a documentation. Documentation is a sophisticated approach to purposefully using the environment to explain the history of the projects and the school community. It does not simply refer to the beautiful classroom artwork commonly found throughout the schools. And even though it is often incorporates the concrete examples of both the process and the products that are a part of child's education, it is more than just that. It is a fundamental way of building the connections. Co-construction increases the level of knowledge being developed. This occurs when active learning happens in conjunction with working with others, that is, having opportunities for the work to be discussed, questioned, and explored. The questions facilitate more connection and extension. There is an opportunity to bring in different expertise. Thus, to facilitate co-constructions, the teacher needs to be aggressively listening and foster the collaboration between all the members of the community whenever possible. The real learning takes place when they check, evaluate, and possibly add to the child's work. The long-term projects are studies that encompass the explorations of teachers and children. The flow charts are organized systems of recording the curriculum, planning, and assessment based on the ongoing collaborations and after a careful review. The portfolios are collection of the child's work that demonstrates the child's efforts, progress, and achievement over the time. Now, let us see the environmental support. The environment is similar to that of the Maria Montessori method. Like in Montessori, it is believed that beauty helps the children with the concentration and the setting is aesthetically pleasing. In this approach, the environmental is like a home-like approach. The home-like atmosphere is designed to help the children feel comfortable and learn the practical life issues. Each child provided a place to keep her own belongings, and documentation is a major part of this environmental setup, which illustrates both the process and the product. In documentation, the child is seen as an individual but also in relationship with the group, with various possibilities for the individual. Next comes to the environment. Environment in this approach is aesthetically pleasing, comfortable, and is a center of learning. There are places which allows the children to work with few children, a large group, and sometimes with the teacher alone. they have a special studio or workshop which is used in documenting the child's work, transcript of their descriptions and photographs of their activities and representation of their projects. Next comes the teacher. The teacher is a co-explorer in the learning experiences with the children, and the teacher provokes ideas, the problem solving and conflict resolution to take ideas from the children and return them for further exploration. To organize the classrooms, it is accessible and interesting to the child, and the documentation of the children is in progress. The curriculum. The central part of the curriculum concept in this approach is the project, because through the project, the child will be able to explore a concept or a topic and will be able to deal in small groups. The projects are usually done in artwork, and when they do art, they learn to draw and formulate their own concept. This is about the Reggio Emilia approach towards the early childhood education. After this, let us look after the fifth approach, or the world of education. The world of education. This is based on the profound understanding of human development that addresses the needs of a growing child. The world of teachers strive to transform education into an art that educates the whole of the child, the heart and the hands as well as the head. The environment in this approach. The first thing you may notice when you enter this world of school is that the care given to the building. The walls are usually painted in a lively colors and adorned with students' artwork. The evidence of students' activity is everywhere to be found, and every desk holds a uniquely created main lesson book. The children. The children learning relate what they learn from their own experiences, that they are interested and alive, and when they learn, it becomes their own. World of schools are designed to foster this kind of learning. The teachers. The teachers in World of School are dedicated to generating an inner enthusiasm for learning within every child and allowing motivation to rise from within and helping the capacity of joyful lifelong learning. The curriculum. In this approach to early childhood education, it is largely experiential, initiative and sensory based. The emphasis is on providing worthwhile practical activities for the children to imitate and allowing them to learn through the examples. So, today we have understood the different approaches to early childhood education. We have seen the Montessori method of approach, the high or scope approach, and the Reggio Emilia approach, and the Waldorf educational approach. Each approach has a different environment, materials, and the methods of educating the early childhood educators. So, in Maria Montessori, we have seen the didactic material usage and self-learning where the errors are less in the children. Like that, in each approach, they have their own the kind of ideas or the materials or the environment for the early childhood education program. Hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.